Hello everyone. So today we will be continuing with the same chapter, which is named as Motion and Time. So in the last video, we have already seen about how the speed and time are related, how distance is calculated. Okay, now let us jump further in the chapter. Let us see that how we can measure the speed. Okay, so let us see measurement of speed. Now we already know that speed of an object can be measured if we know the distance which is covered by the object and the time taken to cover that distance. So we can say that speed is equal to distance upon time taken by the object to cover that distance, right? So let us see how we can calculate the speed with the help of an example. So here it is given that the distance between two stations is 240 kilometer. A train takes 4 hours to complete to cover this distance. Calculate the speed of the train. Now for calculating this, we know already to calculate the speed, we have the formula, that is distance upon time taken. Okay. So now here in the questions, there are few given things. So what are these given things? Distance is given, that is 240 kilometers, and time taken is given, that is 4 hours. So we have time taken and distance. Now we can calculate the speed very easily, right? The speed is equal to 240 kilometers upon 4 hours, which is equal to 60 kilometer per hour. So we can say that the speed of the train is 60 kilometer per hour, and by which it can cover 240 kilometers in 4 hours. I hope this is clear, and by this formula you can calculate the speed if you have given distance and time. Now if there is, for example, if there is a speed given and time taken is given, and you have to calculate the distance, can you do that? Yes, obviously you can do that. So for that, what would be the formula? It would be speed into time taken, which will give you the distance. Okay, so this is how you can mold this formula to get any three of the things which are there: either speed, either distance, or either the time taken. Okay, now let us see how we can represent this with the help of graph, which is graphical representation. So there is first graph, which is bar graph. Now why it is named as bar graph? Because there are these bars which are there, which are going to represent the scale, right? So here we have x-axis, y-axis, and there are bars, and that is the reason it is called as bar graph. Then we have pie chart. It is just called as pie chart because it looks like a pie, right? So it is a pie chart which represents different data. And we have line graph. The line graph is named as line graph because we represent the data with the help of a single line. Okay, so these are different types of graph. Now we are going to represent the time taken and distance with the help of any of these graph. Let us take an example of line graph. So let us represent it, distance time graph. So here we have a table which gives us the data. Here in one side we have time and the other side gives us distance. Now let us make graph out of it. So here I have taken one axis, drawn one axis, then the second axis. Here we have x axis, then y axis, and here that is zero. It's not zero, it's O basically. It is origin, okay, from where the line starts or the axis starts. Okay, now we will number this 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Again over y axis 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We will name the x axis. Here we have time, which is in minutes, and on y axis we have distance, which is in kilometer. Okay, so now let us draw the graph. So first we have 0 time and 0 distance. So which would be over here. Okay, so we have drawn a point over here. Then we have 1. Okay, time is 1 and distance is also 1. So here the distance is 1 and the time is 1. So it will be somewhat over here. Okay, so we will mark it over here. Then we have time as 2 and distance as 2 as well. So it would be somewhat over here, kind of. Yes, So I'm not using ruler, so it might go somewhat here and there, but you have to use ruler scale so that it would come very proper. Then we have third, that is 3 and 3. So here it is here, and the distance is 3. So it goes somewhat here. I hope it would be straight. Okay, it's not straight. Okay, so now we are going to draw a line with it. Okay, so let me decide. I will choose this color. And it is not going straight, I know. Okay, I need to erase it. Okay, don't mind if it doesn't go straight, but you can make it straight with the help of ruler. Okay, you have to join all these points. So somewhat we get the straight line with this line graph. Okay, you can match if you want. You can match with the help of dotted lines that have you drawn the distance correctly or and time taken correctly or not. You can match it with the help of this. I know it's not that much proper because I'm not using ruler or scale. You need to do it with the help of ruler or scale. This is just to show you how a line graph can be made. Okay, so this is how we can make time and distance. We can graph the time and distance on this line graph. Okay, you need to, whenever you go with graph, you need to specify what is on x-axis, what is on y-axis, and the number and the scale, which means the distance between the z x-axis, the numbers. Okay, you can see over here 0 और 1 के बीच में जितना डिस्टेंस है उतना ही 1 और 2 के, उतना ही 3, 2 और 3 के, राइट? सो दैट स्केल शुड बी प्रॉपर इन बोथ द केसेस. ओके, सो दिस इज हाउ यू ड्रॉ द ग्राफ. आई होप ऑल थिंग्स आर वेरी मच क्लियर, एंड इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट लेट मी नो, आई विल बी क्लियरिंग इट. ओके, सो दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट द चैप्टर. थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग. टेक केयर ऑफ योर सेल्फ एंड स्टे सेफ.